Hey, here we go again. New park, new day. Actually, it's the very next day from walking the park yesterday. So, let's get to it. I was just out here poking around. The ice is expanding because of the sun. So I was over here just listening to it. It's kind of cool. And walking around, this is a group camp area. We're gonna come out back down that way when we come back. But I've walked this trail a couple times actually. They say it's about 3 miles, but for some reason I think it's longer. So I got the tracking on. Yeehaw. And I wanna see if it is actually longer. But anyway, we gotta go down this parking area and cross the road down here to get on the trail. There are a few people here today when I drove in. It's chilly. The wind is going right through my sweatshirts. It's still a little chill. But I was thinking, since the wind's in our face, coming right at us right now, and the sun is shining on that ridge over there, which is where we're going. Maybe we'll see some wildlife hanging out on the sunny ridge where there's no wind. Whew. It's supposed to be another warm day, but it is early though. I left the house way early today. Just want to get out of there. Going. So we're going to move it along here and get off the road and get my blood pumping a little bit. I'm kind of poking around over there. We're in the wide open now, kind of cold. So the camera might shake around a little bit while I'm hoofing it. This is Maple Basswood Trail, and this part's 1.5 miles, and then we come back. That hiking club trail is what we're doing. It says 2.9 miles. Let's see if it's right. We'll check it when we get back. A little more, I'll slow down so I'm not so shaking around with the camera here. Right now we're basically walking around that lake all the way around and a little bit further down than the bottom of it. But yeah, we're basically in the middle of another Minnesota swamp. Starting to feel better already, just being closer to the trees. No, the wind's going up over top of us. Ooh. Chilly. What's that? Oh, that's a person coming. I saw a shadow moving. I was like, holy shit, is that a deer? Morning. See any wildlife?
Pardon?
Did you see any wildlife?
Heard.
You heard some?
I haven't seen nothing too much. It's
been usually the big bucks hang right around that little bridge. I don't know if you crossed that.
We have before, yeah. Not today we didn't, but okay. We went up north. We're up to the north, but usually that's where we see deer up in there. But
oh, okay.
Not much happening up there that we've seen.
But yeah, it's a little chilly. I figured on the sunny side of the ridge they'd be laying down here, but
yeah, a lot of times they're up in that area too feeding, but
yeah.
I haven't seen nothing today.
Well, we'll take a leak.
Warmer, maybe moving around more.
Yeah, oh yeah, I can't believe how nice it is. Well, let's see what we can find. The ground is a little froze. And not a little froze, it's froze. It's not mud like it was yesterday. Yet. If it warms up like they said it will, this will be mud. Yeah, last year, a little later than this, like well into March, I hiked this, and that bridge that I was just talking about with those people, I was crossing it, gabbing as usual. And I hear crash, crash, crash. I look off to my left, and a nice buck just poured up out of the creek that it crosses. The bridge I was standing on, anyway. Yeah, it was nice. It was a big buck. Okay, we're at the sea post. Should be right down here somewhere. Yep, right here. So, yeah, those guys went the north way, this way. That's a nice hike. They really moved it. But we're going to go around this lake here. Hidden Lake, 1.3 miles. Huh. Well, I could be wrong, but for some reason I thought my tracker recorded it longer. That's not bad. Somebody had a fat bike out in this trail. That'd be fun. I'm seeing a 4-inch tire tread every now and then. slow it down a little bit, take breaks now and then, so I'm not so noisy that if the deer are going to be in here, they'll be right along this sunny side here. Of course, they're used to people a little bit, but because it is a state park, but still, they have instincts. I'm sure I'll have enough time to hike a couple trails today. I got here early. I was here, parked with the van off, and out walking around at 9:30. So it's not much later than that right now. I even brought a little bit of camping stuff and some food if I felt like cooking. This is the Red Oak Trail there, and I do believe that you can go that way. Yeah, see, hiking club trail. Yeah, we're going to go this way. It all comes back around and ties into the one we were just on. But I've never actually done this part, so this will be cool. And this puts us right up into the sunny ridge. For them to be laying down. You can see how sunny the sun shines on that ridge over there. looks like it kind of turns and goes right to it. Oh wow, this can be quite a hike. This is an incredible area, really nice area. Glad I came early. I've really been feeding through here on this sunny side. You can see how clear it is. You can see through the woods quite a ways. I need to go up a little bit, don't you? This is pretty steep. A lot steeper than anything I hiked yesterday. We're not even to the top yet. What about you? Almost wished I saved this for coming down, but I really didn't want to walk in the wind. Ooh. That's a butt burner right there. This old boy. Sunny ridgetop. This would be an ideal spot. ideal spot. No wind, plenty of food. There's acorns on the ground where I'm walking. Sunny. I'm surprised we're not seeing anything. Pretty easy woods to see me through, though. I mean, the deer can see me 100 yards away through these woods. If any of you are saying, what the heck kind of bird is that? To be honest, I don't know. I was actually looking for it while I was walking, but now it completely shut right up. And I don't see it, so it must have flew off. Oh yeah, I don't know what the heck that was. Oh. I can't see them anywhere. First I thought maybe it was some kind of woodpecker, but it's not slamming on a tree anywhere. Huh. All right, we'll let them be. I'm sure we're making them nervous, that's what it. Oh, jeez. Hurry, I'm being quiet, thinking I'm going to see a deer. Here comes a runner.
Well, I keep looking, too, but I wouldn't hear him. I got music playing.
Oh.
Enjoy your hike.
You too. Yeah, that was... All of a sudden, I heard something, and it kept getting louder and louder. This is a very popular park with the people that live in Alexandria, Minnesota. It's not far from here. It's a little bit of a drive, but it's close enough where this will be a favorite park for people that live there. I should actually go there later. If you watched my last video, that's the city I was talking about that has multiple of every type of store. You know, the Walmart, the Kmart, the Targets, they're all there. The little mini shopping malls, all that, they're all there. Multiple car dealerships, so many gas stations that two or three and four of them are the same. Okay, where's our, we need to pay attention here. We gotta look for our little hike. There it is. Our little hiking club sign. Damn, what a trailhead. We got one from there, one there, one there, and one there. Sheesh. But here's our little marker right over here. As long as we have that hiking club trail marker, we're going the right way. It is so much nicer now that the sun's shining on me with no wind. Way more comfortable. Nice little clearing. I haven't really been stopping and looking around much for no particular reason. A lot of fallen tree, deadfall. Stepped on a rolling rock. Made my foot go 6-8 inches further. Alright, I'm not sure what the split off is here, but you can tell it's not used much. Probably loops back around over here. And I don't see our... Oh, okay. Maybe because that's the easier section. I see a green circle with a easy sign in it. This might be a little tougher. I don't know. But I didn't see a hiking club trail sign, so we're going to stay on this. So many acorns on the ground, it's crazy. Songbirds are starting to wake up. They're fluttering around now. Starting to see a few of them. Oh, she's on her way back. Or took a different loop, probably. Hello again. Good to see people my age out and about, especially running. Tree roots hidden under the leaves. Here's our sign. I can hear the wind. I really hope we don't come out into an opening. I might catch a little of it walking alongside the lake. I'm starting to feel it now. There's two squirrels fighting. I knew I heard something. That's the reason why I turned around a minute ago. Well, we've turned completely around and faced the sun now, so hopefully it's not a distraction for the camera. Step in a hole, fool. It's a nice bedding area right there. In normal circumstances, it may not be here because of the people in the trail. Well, I don't know. What do you think? Being we've kind of turned and we're turning back, did it feel like we done half of 1.29 miles or 2.9 miles? I don't know. I know I'm a slow walker, but I'm pretty sure I just covered more area than a mile and a half. We'll find out. It's really starting to turn out to be a nice day. Yesterday started to, first it was getting hazy and then it clouded up, but then the sun came back out. And it's kind of doing the same thing here. It's a little bit overcast, but the sun's trying to burn it off. And the wind's trying to push it out. I hope. Not bringing it in. Truthfully, I expected a lot more mud here than where I was yesterday. This place has been dry for a while. I think a rabbit lives there. I would, although coyote can get in that pretty easily. Well, next time I come, I'll have to do the North Trail. There's a handful of trails I haven't done in here yet, truthfully. I usually like to do the longer ones, so the, you know, 0.9 mile and mile or 0.6 mile, I usually don't bother with those. love that anticipation of not knowing what's going to be over the ridge when you get there. I'm always expecting something to be standing there. Isn't it crazy? Out of all these trails, out of all this craziness, we actually got to go this way. That's the way we came from. There's about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 trails come together right here. That's wild. I feel sorry for the cross-country skiers. That's quite a big thing here in Minnesota. I mean, there's trails like snowmobile trails, but for cross-country skiers all over the state. I tried that a couple times when I was really young, 20 or younger, and I picked up on it really quick. It's just, I don't know, somehow lost interest and never really got into it. Downhill skiing, that's different. I got into that and never stopped. Very expensive hobby or sport, whatever way you want to look at it. Very expensive. I was almost positive that we just did that little loop twice, but I didn't want to say anything until I really recognized something, and that little sign back there was it. So somehow, when I said, when we got to that 5 junction intersection, instead of going left, I had to go another trail, but I didn't see the other hiking club trail sign. So when we get there, we'll just figure it out. It's not that far away now. I had a feeling that's what happened. It started to look familiar. Of course, when you've only been here once, you doubt yourself. So we got to see the loop twice, which is going to throw our distance measurement off by that much. So much for getting an accurate reading. I don't know how I missed it. I stood there and looked around, but oh well. That's what I get for not looking at the map board. Nice enough day. I won't mind doing this whole loop twice, to tell you the truth. I wouldn't put you guys through it, but freaking really nice out here. Just a walk in the park today. I'm right. That's the tree I said, hey, that'd make a neat rabbit home. And I'm like, no, coyote can get it pretty easily. That's the same tree. So we just did this loop twice. Was all because I wanted to climb this hill again. I enjoyed it so much the first time. That's what I get for not paying attention. Maybe this time when we come up over, there will be something standing there. Apparently not. Well, here's our five trail hub. You guys want to do that loop again? Let's just do it the right way. Oh, come on now. Gotta get my stuff situated. H, huh? Yeah, okay. We're way up here. Whoops. Get that off of there. So, wow, that is really odd. Okay. Let's go either one of those A and B, go to the same trail. I see what we did. Yeah. We added red oak to it. Okay. Anyway, you guys probably couldn't even see what I was looking at. I had to try to figure out what the hell I was doing. All right, let's go this way. Stand on this ski trail. Yeah, here we go. This is the reason why I missed it the first time. Because you don't see another one until you get way up here. Whoa. There's a nice game trail. I don't know how good it shows on camera, but yeah. Scoots right up along that ridge. I actually saw this one first, which you can barely even see. That was some kind of big bird just flew off right here. Coming up on the lake here pretty quick. Or wide open wind part of it, let's put it that way. Okay, we made it back to the main line, I believe, yeah. You can see we're right here now. So, yeah, this is where we started. Whoops, this is where we started. We went all the way up and around here, ended up here. Let's go all the way around here now. This won't take that long. I'm pretty sure this is the part that they say is 2.9 miles. I'm pretty damn sure we've already done more than 2.9 miles. Oop. Wow. The sun is warm. Very warm. They weren't lying today. Yesterday they said 50, and it might have got 50, but it didn't feel it because the wind was whipping like 25, 28 miles an hour. Man, it was chilly all day. You just never really got the chill out of you. Get around to the east side of this little lake here. It won't be so bad. We'll be tucked in the woods a little more. This is the bridge that I was talking about. Way earlier, when we very first started, and bumped into those two people. I was coming from the other direction, not paying attention. Whoa, that was a gunshot. What the hell is that doing in here? Right in here. I was coming across the bridge and I got two steps onto the bridge and he was laying back in there. Paw, 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 paw. Just plowing through the water. It's crazy. Huge rack. I saw it really good from here. Yeah, he was right over there. That bigger of the two trees, he was just behind that land down. And I come stomping on this thing. Woof, off he went. He ran right in front of me, right here. That was pretty cool. This must have flooded out or something at one point. I just put a whole bunch of rock in here. This ain't natural. They filled this. That was almost hard to walk on. Oh yeah, that sun is warm. Ooh. In the summertime, if you're hiking this part of the trail, you better have bug spray on. Crap, I wasn't paying attention. There's an eagle house here somewhere. Eagle nest. Maybe it's further down. I forgot about that. Yeah, I'm not seeing it. I thought it was here. I thought it was right in this opening. Unless it fell finally. Or unfortunately, I shouldn't say finally. But I thought it was right here. Right in this opening. Whew. That was a little steeper than I thought it was. Cool view across the lake though. Almost looks like there's no ice on it. Starting to turn blue, getting thinner. Oh, take a break here for a second. Rest of it's pretty much wooded now. That's a woodpecker. He's a happy little woodpecker. One thing I'll say about this park, they go right to the border with their trails. I mean, you can see, no trespassing. This is the line right here. I see the posted sign. There's a clearing through the woods right there. That's private property from there up. In fact, as we go along, you'll see houses up on the ridge here on the right. Which means the people that actually live and own that land right there can hunt that. But as soon as they step over this trail into here, they're illegal. I don't think there's any laws that says you've got to be so many feet or yards or whatever away from a state park. In fact, I'm pretty sure there's no law. Is if you buy land that borders it, that's your land. You would think that's the way it is. But I guess it depends on where you live. Because, like I was saying yesterday, the state that I was born and raised in had all kinds of stupid laws that we had to deal with. Like no hunting on Sunday. That was the dumbest thing ever. Couldn't wait to move out of that state just for that dumbass law alone. But it is what it is. And they are still that way to this day. I remember right, we'll start to turn left here as we get to the top. There's a trail on the private property that butts up against us. That was a doozy. That one got the old butt woke up. Yikes. That explains why the bench is here. Well, I don't think you can see it, but through those trees right there, there's a house. That's one. And right there, there's another. Nice trail. Oh. Oh man. Okay. We're not far till we get to the end. Yeah. It's like a cabin right there. Not an old settlement cabin, but a newer cabin. Well, if it wasn't for doing that loop twice, we'd be done. Went for that one. I'm burning my knees out. When I go downhill, I try to really like rock my feet with a smooth motion. So really put this little extra strain on the top of my knee just to build that muscle. Well, if you made it this far, so far in the video, A, thank you, and B, you must really love backcountry trail hiking. Some of my videos make good videos for no audio, just put on your music. Maybe it has a little music going with some hiking. That way, you ain't got to listen to me rambling on either. But just to have some cool screensaver, you know, you're hanging out in the living room doing work on your computer, put the music on, watch me walk through the woods. It'd be really cool if I could put my own music to it and really wouldn't have much narrated audio if I could add music. I can add music, but it's all stuff I don't really want to use. It's free. And if you don't use free music, then you get copyrighted. And in some places, they just take it right down. So I try not to have the camera on if there's music playing, like if I'm at a festival or something like that. I try to wait till the band takes a break before I turn the camera on and do any talking or whatever. What in the hell? Okay. Not sure. So we having fun? Well, other than our little double take of the little loop, that was a pretty nice hike. I mean, even with that, it's still a nice hike. I want to try to get as many interpretive trails hiked in before, you know, the ticks and stuff start to come out and about. We got some warm days coming this week. Really warm. In the 50s. That's going to be interesting. I can go up, take a left, and so we shall. The whole idea of a hiking club, if you're wondering, because you might have been able to pay attention enough to, I don't know why that's there, that's been there for years. It's a cover for something, but whatever. Anyway, I don't know if all of them or most of them are within the state parks. There's hiking club trails, and you have to hike it in order to get the password. Like this hiking club trail password is Oak Trail. I saw it on the sign when we were hiking. And each park will have a different password. And I don't know if there's some kind of a paperwork or something that, you know, like you hand in or some crap like that. I don't know. I really gotta research that, because, you know, it's just easier to talk about it if you know what you're talking about. But I'm not one of those club kind of guys, you know. I do my stuff myself. I do my own thing. I'm too spontaneous. You know, some days I want to hike, some days I want to hunt, some days I don't want to do anything, and I don't want to be controlled to do it. Selfish, I know, but I get along with my people better. I'm on my own. But at least I can admit it. You know, I don't fake anything. Getting closer. Feel the wind whipping right down this trail, right in our face now. Oh, actually feels kind of good now that it's warmed up. Up around this corner, we'll be in the group camp section. Like when you send your kids off to camp, that kind of camp. Those cabins, there's a bunch of them. I'll show you when we get up here. Since you are nice enough to hang around to the end, see the whole trail, I'll show you some of these cabins. I did this when I was a kid. You know, the Boy Scouts and all that. And then we had other camps, summer camps. I was into it. My brother wasn't into it as much. And I just got finished saying that I'm not a people person, but when you're a kid, it's different, I think. You gotta show off. But yeah, each one of these cabins holds, I don't know how many people. I've never been in them, but I could imagine, you know, 6 or 8, because they're just cots. And then I think this one up here is the bathroom. I'm pretty sure bathroom and showers. Pretty neat place. I don't come up here in the summer just because it is a camp. I mean, you're allowed. It's not like you can't come up here. The whole thing is a state park. But you know, a lot of people go to camp because they want to get away. So, but the actual trail that we were just hiking goes right along the ridge, right along the edge of that, up around to where I parked the van. Yeah, those are the bathrooms and showers. Yeah. These are all cabins. This is a bigger one. This might be the mess hall, now that I think about it, because it's got more picnic tables all the way around the whole building, and it's got a fireplace. And yeah, that might be where they all eat or gather. And this building here in front of us, I think, is the counselor's building. But, pretty cool. Let's get back over here, go around the buildings, get back on that trail. No smoking, no pets. Well, I got a little lookout here. It might be a fishing pier. I doubt it though. It's probably a lookout. Oh, there's a couple of them. One over there too. Yeah, it's just a lookout. Our little personal beach area. We can hang out. That's kind of cool. Yeah. Good view. Kind of slopes downhill. When I stepped on it, I was almost running down the hill here. Really shallow. What? I like dogs. Come here. I like dogs. Oh, you're okay. You probably smell my cats. Yeah, you should bring it. How you doing, guys?
Good, how are you?
Yeah, not too bad.
Beautiful day out here.
Oh my gosh, yeah. That was a treat. Yeah, that was pretty cool. Two of the most friendliest dogs you'll ever have, right there. Got a little rock pile there to slow it up. Oh man, I might be fishing this. Not that I could see them right now. Yeah, find some pools up in there somewhere. You might catch a fish or two that come out of this lake. When the water gets high, they get trapped up in there. Oh, I'm glad we came back to the trail. We gotta hike up a hill. Hell yeah. What a way to end it. Oh, that must be just a ridge trail. Because this hiking trail goes this way. Dang it. Oh well, I could have went that way, I guess, but I wanna have the whole hiking trail on my tracker. Hiking club trail, I mean. Yeah, the Ridge Trail must be something totally different. That woman was just hightailing it. Well, next time I'll do that one. Yeah, they just joined right back up. So I guess in a sense they're both hiking club now. This just happens to be the original. Well, I'm not hungry. I'm thirsty. I got my water bottle with me, but we're so close to the end. I'm gonna wait until I get to the cooler and get a ice cold one. I bet that ice isn't even thick enough to walk on now. I'm guessing. I don't know, maybe it is. We've had so much warm weather. I don't think I would trust it. Okay, one more killer view of the lake here. That's not the lake we hiked around. Obviously, we'd be on the other side. We'd be coming from that way. I don't think there is a trail that hikes around that lake. It's all private property on the other side anyway. I mean, you can see houses over there reflecting the sun, but you know what time it is. That's my ride. Time to say goodbye.